Hey guys, this morning on today's Tactical Arts and Crafts, I wanted to show how to raise the cheek weld on an AK47 or, you know, whatever rifle you may have. If you purchased a cheek rest and it's just not giving you enough height, we want to do a how-to on how to raise that up some and not spend a whole lot of money. So anyway, AK47, I have a Tapco adjustable stock and a CAA CP-2 one-inch cheek riser that fits on collapsible stocks. So the problem I've been having is with a barrel rail mounted optic, I can't get the cheek weld that I want. And so, you know, I kept going through my head thinking about different materials. How can I raise up my cheek weld without spending a whole lot of money and getting into complicated shit? So this is what I came up with. Closed cell foam. And what I was going to use is just a GI issued sleeping pad, but I was in a big box store yesterday and came across these tactical koozies. They're tactical because they're black, and they're only a dollar. So I bought two of these because I knew how much I needed to raise the cheek weld up. So I figured, hell, I'll just buy two of these and we'll put them on. So for the rest of this demonstration, what you're gonna need are, of course, your tactical scissors, tactical tape, a tactical razor blade, tactical glue, and your tactical koozies that you bought for a dollar. And for the rest of this, I don't need the rifle. We're just gonna be working with the cheek piece. Alright, so I went ahead and split this one in half, and what we're going to be doing is gluing it to the cheek rest, like that, and then we're going to do a second layer. So as you can see, we have too much material, and that's where our tactical scissors and tactical razor blade are going to come into play. So I get this lined up a little bit, we're gonna start cutting. Let's start about there and go to there. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this and get it on, and I'll be right back and show you what we did. Okay guys, so I went ahead, I've got the excess trimmed off the way I want it to, right? And so what I did is took my tactical tape to hold it in position, because if you can see, there's curves on the inside, right? And you know, want to keep that to the lines of the cheek piece. So what we're gonna do is take our tactical razor here and just trace on the inside of the cheek piece against the foam. You know, follow the lines of follow the lines of the cheek piece on the foam, so we can trim it and it'll match up exactly. So essentially all we're doing is just scoring the foam. Don't have a good line there. We're scoring the inside of the foam so that we can pull it off and then trim it one more time before we actually start gluing it to the And I just wanted to show y'all this part, show you what I did, in case y'all are wondering. Sweet. So, alright, we pull our tactical tape off. And now, if you kind of bend it back, you can see your scored lines. Well, I didn't score so well on those, but we'll trim real quick this part. And then we'll stick it back on there and finish the back. Now and again, guys, this is for function, not for fucking beauty, so now, all we're doing is making our rifle fit us better. You know, this is for use, not for, you know, a gun that's going to be a safe queen and isn't going to see any use. You know, you don't have to spend a bunch of money to get stuff that is gonna work and probably work better than the $400 piece of shit name brand thing you bought just so you can impress your buddies. You know, I'm all about field expedient modifications, and so I'm taking lessons learned from that and just translating it into something that is a little more permanent. You know, because essentially, all you really have to do, and if I was in the field, what I would do, is just take a GI mat, cut it up, take some duct tape, tape it on, and it'd be done. And it'd work fine. You know, but for this, we're just kind of cleaning it up a little. And making it a little more permanent. Alright, so, as you can see, we've cut, followed the lines pretty good. Probably trim a little bit more off there. You know, that way it's not completely butt ugly. But, you know, again, we're not going for buddy impressions here. We're going for what is going to fit your rifle to your face so that you can make more accurate shots and come out ahead. So that's all this is about. Alright, I think we're good to go. So now, here's the fun part. We're gonna glue this first layer on. We're gonna let it dry for a little bit before we move on to the second layer. Alright, so, tactical glue. Stuff is awesome. Smear it on. And if you haven't used this stuff, guys, if you built a ghillie suit, you know how bad this shit stinks. So, or hell, if you fix shoes with it. Open a window, let it air out, because this stuff will stink up everywhere. And then, about 20 minutes later, you're going to have a massive headache. You ain't going to be able to shake. So, our glue smeared on. Yeah, don't be shy. centered on the inside of our first layer of cheek rest. And when you're doing this with sugar, you know, anything will work, Gorilla Glue, anything that gives a good bond, hell, you can JB weld it if you wanted to. If you want to break up some epoxy, then it'll really never come off. You know, do both sides, and you're going to let it tack up for a little bit. Actually, this is getting pretty techie pretty quick. Sweet. Alright, so we got the inside, we got the outside. Now we're going to make the two surfaces together. That there. Now we're going to take some tape. You know, and the other thing, you can use clips, whatever you want. Basically, we're just trying to get a good firm hold, some compression on it, so it's got time to dry. And you know, all your surfaces is made up really well. This is just painter's tape. Peels right off. It holds when it's on there, and then comes right off. That way you won't be tearing up the foam. Alright, so we're going to let this dry. I'm going to let it dry about an hour. And then... Hey guys. So it's been about an hour, and I went ahead and pulled the tape off. So it's pretty tacky. It's not all the way dry, but that's okay because we're not done. we just wanted a hold good enough so we could do the second part. So I went ahead while I was waiting and repeated. All we're going to be doing is repeating steps one. I already trimmed it to fit. So, you know, again, all we're going to be doing now is taping this on, lining it up with the first layer. And then we're gonna trim all the excess off. So, let's do that. So, there we go. There. Make sure when you're putting these layers on that you tighten it down really tight, because you got to remember this is getting glued, so it's gonna be a little tight in there because it's gonna be forming to the first layer. So you want to make sure it all kind of lines up. And so on this part, we're not going to be necessarily following the plastic part of the cheek rest. We're going to be following the first layer of foam. So, and it doesn't have to be exact, because once it's complete, we're going to be trimming excess off after it's dry. And honestly, I think I can trim with it on there. And follow the lines. It's a little bit easier with the second layer. tactical scissors come in handy. They're so tactical. You guys, I joke about the tactical shit a lot, but I mean, really is, it's a fucking joke. I mean, these are scissors. This is glue. It's tape. There's nothing. You know, tactical only relates to tactics, and I don't know how it got such a cliche word, because if you talk to anybody that does quote-unquote tactical work, they don't call that shit their tactical flashlight or their tactical forearm. It's a flashlight. It's a forearm. It's a stock. There's, you know, they wear pants, not tactical pants. So I kind of clown on it because you see people, and I know guys that if it doesn't say tactical on it, they will not buy it because somehow that word tactical makes it better. So I'm just clowning. I'm not putting anybody down. I just, you know, the thing that kills me is the people that spend massive amounts of money on shit that don't necessarily need to. Now, granted, I will side with sometimes you get what you pay for. You know, sometimes if you cheap out, it's going to bite you in the ass. Whereas if you got the full price name brand item, you might have come out ahead. Now again, and especially is true nowadays with all the outsourcing that's done, sometimes that $400 piece of shit is the same $100 knockoff thing, just without the label on it. And that's why I like to check it out, you know? Check out the cheaper versions first. Look it over. I mean, 9 times out of 10, if you're seeing that much similarity, it probably came out of the same factory in China. And it probably is the exact same thing, just without the name brand stamped on it. So, just stuff to think about. And then there's other times, and there's some great products out there, and I'm not putting down any brands at all, because, you know, there is some great stuff. I'm just talking about the general, I don't know, snobbery, or what does Nut and Fancy say, tactical elitists. You know, that if it's not this brand, it's shit. And this brand makes me a better shot, because why? Because you paid $400 for it? Or $1,000? You know? And I'll tell you this too. Over the course of my lifetime, I found that if I start with worse equipment, and I'm not talking about a gunfight situation, I'm just saying in general, but especially when it comes to training, if I've got to start out with a shit rifle and shit optics and have to learn with that, it forces me to become more skillful, because it's not the product or the rifle or, you know, whatever else. It's me having to learn how to deal with sharpening my skills and not relying on gear to make me better. All right, so not pretty, but it's gonna do. I think we're ready to slap some glue on, wrap this puppy up. And guys, this is, again, it's an ugly mod, but, you know, like I said, I have no ego or self-esteem issues wrapped up in how pretty my weapon systems are. Because pretty or tactical does not get you home. Cool. It's ugly as shit, but we're gonna do it anyway. And I could have done this better. I don't give a shit. This is for function. This is strictly for function. This is not for beauty. I just wanted something, you know, look a little better than tape on there. But I'm not looking to spend a ton of money. So, we're gonna repeat the same steps. I'm gonna swab the inside with the glue. And you wanna get a good coat, especially around the edges, because you don't want this shit peeling off. All right, guys, so we got it glued, and now we're just taping it on. In this part, we're gonna let it sit overnight just to get a good cure. And then what we'll do once it's cured is go ahead and trim it up, just clean it up a little bit. Get the excess shoe goo on. So, that's probably gonna be about it for this portion. I'm really taping this part down because, you know, the first layer isn't all the way dry. So this is just to compress it all and make sure we get a good hold on it. Alright, so there's that. Like I said, we're gonna let this sit overnight and get real hard, and then what we'll come back and do is went a little too short, so I'm just gonna trim the bottom layer, peel the glue off with a razor blade. Just kind of clean it up a little bit, shape the foam, and then it'll be done. So, see you in a little bit. Hey guys, so this dried overnight and here it is. It is good to go. Trimmed off a little excess, wiped off the excess shoe goo with some adhesive remover. Cleaned it up a little bit. I may go back and take a Dremel on a sanding disc and just kind of level it out, but you know, essentially you get it, the idea. This is nothing pretty. It's for function, not for tactical cool points. It works. It's a good addition, especially, you know, even if you just want to add some padding to a cheek piece, these things just get you a koozie, cut it up, and slap it on there. Like I said, if you don't want to go the process of gluing, tape works. And so that's it, you know. Just going to clean this up a little bit with a Dremel and a sanding disc, and that'll be done. So we're good to go. That's it. I just wanted to do a little how-to. I hope you enjoyed it, and as always, please subscribe.